immediately after the collapse of Lehman Brothers, we saw something that is quite unusual in the international policy community, which is a very quick agreement that something needs to be done very quickly about an area of finance, right? So we had the Financial Stability Board being created in 2009 with a specific aim of creating a regulatory framework for shadow banking. So the idea was shadow banking needs to be regulated and taken out, and the systemic risk that come from shadow banking minimized, if not eliminated altogether. And what we see now, 10 years from the collapse of Lehman Brothers, is something that I would think it's a paradox that speaks in some ways to the power of finance. And this paradox is that there are several global initiatives that are trying to introduce shadow banking through the back door in developing countries, but under the term market-based finance, right? Remember, I defined shadow banking as the growing importance of securities markets, derivatives markets, and wholesale funding markets. And I would like to give you three examples of these global initiatives that I think are very important for developing countries and should be on the radar of developing countries in the various spaces where they negotiate. The first one is, of course, the Financial Stability Board's reform of the shadow banking agenda. What started initially as the idea that we have to really regulate these securitization activities, these new types of shadow banks that are providing financing for high risk, high leverage activities, gradually got transformed into a more sort of normative project of re-engineering financial systems. And in 2015, Mark Carney, who's the head of the FSB, but also the head of the Bank of England, said, we have to transform shadow banking into resilient market-based finance. In other words, we have to think about creating more securities markets and more derivatives markets in developing countries. The second initiative, that is also a global initiative pushed by the G20, initially by the G8, but now by the G20, by the IMF and the World Bank, is the Local Currency Bond Market Initiative. And it is the same logic, but in relationship to what we know is the historical experience of developing countries, that says we know historically that developing countries get into trouble because either the state or private corporations issue too much dollar debt. So if we need to go to foreign markets in order to finance our development objectives, we should do it in our own currency rather than in the currency of the US. And at first instance, this is a good idea, right? Because of course it's better to be indebted in your own local currency. But I think if we connect this to the shadow banking agenda, we will see that there are certain dangers in doing so. And I will come back to this in a second. Just to mention the third initiative, which is the newest one, is the World Bank and other MDB, other multilateral development banks initiative called Maximizing Finance for Development. And what this MFD, Maximizing Finance for Development, says is development aid is dead, or if it's not dead, it's really shrinking very rapidly, and there are increasing needs that poor countries have to finance their own development agenda, increasing needs to finance our fight against climate change, our fight against poverty. And if governments cannot do it, we have a set of financial institutions that we call institutional investors, but another name for them is shadow banks, that are sitting on trillions and trillions of US dollars or all sorts of other cash. And wouldn't it be nice if they came to the help of poor countries to finance their projects, right? So the idea is, how can you get a German pension fund to provide financing to a Namibian small farm or to a Namibian infrastructure project? It's very difficult to do it directly, particularly because PPP projects, private public partnership projects for infrastructure, are not working as well as the World Bank would have hoped. So the idea is, let's try to create the kind of tradable instruments or tradable securities that an institutional investor can buy from Namibia and in this way finance and development. And where is the shadow banking story in here? Well, the shadow banking story in here is that the World Bank and the other MDBs are saying, how can we create these new instruments that global institutional investors would find attractive? Well, let's go back to what Lehman did, which is, let's do securitization of infrastructure projects, right? So if you think, for example, of the G20 infrastructure as an asset class project, it is a project of creating the kind of architecture, so this underworld of finance that is very similar to the financial practices of Lehman Brothers that we describe as shadow banking.